Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about inflammatory myelopathy. Acute inflammatory pathology of spinal cord, not secondary to other CNS inflammatory demyelinating disease. Myelitis here, acute classic myelitis, AFM. Guillain-Barré syndrome, GBS, paralytic poliomyelitis. Most common signs symptom, TL, sensory motor or autonomic dysfunction attributable to spinal cord, typically bilateral, well-defined sensory level, band-like dyskinesia, loss of pain and temperature sensation, paraplegia or quadriplegia, back plus minus radicular pain, bladder or bowel dysfunction. AFM, extremely weakness, paralysis following febrile illness, often asymmetric GBS, ascending weakness 2 to 4 weeks after illness or immunization. Other signs symptoms, hypotonia and hyporeflexia initially, spasticity and hyperreflexia over time. Epidemiology, GM. Incident 2 per 500,000 population, 4.6 new cases of idiopathic acute GM per 1 million people per year in USA, 1,200 new cases per year in USA, late winter through spring. AFM, 0.71 per million in patients less than 21 years old, late summer through fall. GBS, 0.5 to 1.5 cases per 100,000 less than 18 years old, rare less than 2 years old. Imaging, GM, diffuse cord swelling, an abnormal signal more than 2 vertebrae segment in length. AFM, abnormal T2 hyperintensity in cord gray matter, often asymmetric. GBS, symmetric prominent enhancement of ventral nerve root in cauda equina. Poliomyelitis, abnormal T2 hyperintensity in anterior horn cell. This is T2MI in a 14-month-old who developed progressive upper and lower extremity weakness, followed by respiratory failure, so diffuse swelling and hyperintensity of the entire cervical and upper thoracic cord. Characteristic of transmyelitis. T2 of the same patient 8 years later, so severe atrophy of the entire cord. Approximately 25% of transmyelitis case will have permanent disability with total or no recovery function. T2MI in a 4 years old with left upper extremity weakness and cerebral ataxia after a febrile illness, so abnormal hyperintense signal in the central gray matter of the cervical cord, especially the anterior horn cell. due to acute flaccid myelitis associated with enterovirus infection. This is Tituama in a teenager with well-nigh vesnial myelitis who presented with fever, bilateral lower extremity weakness, and urinary incontinence, so mild swelling and abnormal gray matter signal in the distal colon. This is Tituama in a 2-year-old who developed quadriparesis 6 days after receiving an influenza vaccine, such swelling and hyperintense signal of the cervical and upper thoracic cord with affaissement of the subarachnoid CSF spaces at the cervical level. Thank you.